Hi, my name is Chris Tenney-Britton, and I have the privilege of getting to be your instructor for the next few weeks here in the Mid-America Center for Ministry course on ethics. Let me start by saying that those of you who are members of the Christian Church, Disciples of Christ, or might one day be, that are pursuing ministry either by an apprentice track or ministry as a commissioned minister, by the time we finish this course, you will have everything you need to demonstrate proficiency in the ethics ministry practice and skills. So you'll have a portfolio that will have, again, your papers, your work will all demonstrate that you have facility and I would say competency in the study of ethics or with the discipline of ethics. Well, I do know a number of you, and there are a number of you I don't really know, maybe have never even been able to see. So I'll tell you a little bit about myself. I am serving as the Northeast Area Minister for the Christian Church Disciples of Christ of Mid-America. I also serve on the Mid-America Ministry team. I have a passion for churches. I understand my personal mission statement to be one that I exist to equip, empower, and encourage. And that's what I see my responsibility to you being, is to be here and to help you be what successful in this course, to equip you, to empower you, not to do it for you, and of course then to encourage you. On the other hand, what that means is it's up to you to do the work that is going to lead to that proficiency, or at the very least demonstrate that proficiency, and hopefully we'll all be all the more integrous because of that. I want us to look today at this syllabus, and I will ask you to pull your syllabus out or pause this video so you can put your hands on that syllabus, and I'm not going to read it word for word, but again, just to make sure that we are all on the same page, or with syllabi here on the same pages. This course does begin officially on September 17th, that is a Tuesday, and it will complete then on November 12th. You can see the objectives that we have. Again, those objectives fall in line with the necessary skills for showing proficiency in ministerial schools and skills and practices in the study of ethics. We have the four required texts: the Bible, which I'm sure you already have, David Callahan's The Cheating Culture, Robin Lovin's Christian Ethics, and then John Maxwell's Ethics 101. That one we will be using to write devotionals each week. We'll take turns writing those devotionals, but the devotionals will come out of Maxwell's book. Recommended reading, of course, would be Eric Harvey, Scott Aretim's book, Ethics for Everyone, and Steve Ventura, Lead Right. Those books will have readings out of those books as we come along. So in addition to these books, there will be readings, writings, maybe a little article here or there. I know we'll have a couple little exercises that will be posted up here in Angel. So when you're looking at your syllabus, and it refers you to information that's provided on the forum, you know that you need to come up here and to pull all that information down. Expectations. Again, I expect you to do the work. That's first and foremost. I went to a college where we had a very strict honor code, and if you did not turn a paper in on time, complete a test when it was supposed to be completed, you had to go to what we had called the honor court and make our case for why we should be able to turn the paper in late or take the test at a later time. And unless there was death or due illness, generally, you lost a portion of a letter grade for that. So that was instilled deeply in me, and I was quite surprised when I got to seminary and then saw it again repeated in doctoral work that you could get away with not turning your papers in on time. Well, we don't have that kind of window here, to be quite honest. I ask that you read the assignments, that you read what's on the forum, that you've read the books, and then you're going to find up here on this forum questions for you to answer. And those questions have to be responded to, not this week, but starting next week. They have to be responded to no later than Tuesday at noon. And that's to allow for conversation between the rest of us. So then we have to then make our responses to those posts by Wednesday at noon. Again, to allow for these interactions, this is what's going to help us learn. One of the reasons I prefer to teach this course in this type of venue is that when we're all trying to do it on a phone or a Skype or a GoToMeeting type of setting, then we talk all over each other and we can't do this. And it's much easier, I think, and we'll just say it that way. It's a lot easier then to be able to do this in this type of sharing format. So work in on time, please. If you do not know how to use Angel, if you're not sure about posting, if this is a first go for you, please get with Crystal Jacobs, who sent you the information, has been sending you the information about this course, also how to access Angel, because we do have a responsibility to know what we're doing here and to be able to be successful in this class. And that, again, is what we really, really want. So you're going to check this syllabus, page 3, lines out the assignments by week, what you're to read. I'll post a video every week, and we will have a devotional. I have the devotional for this week, and so you will find that posted by Monday morning. So if you're up here and it's the weekend, you're reading this, you'll see it by Monday morning so that you can begin to just meditate on those things. It will not be a video devotional, but it will be one to be read, and that I do invite you to read and look at with me. I think that we're covering most of this. You are going to see some part of the questions or the assignments this week will be to sign up for your turn at the devotional. As a recording of this, we have 11 students. Of course, we don't have that many weeks. What is it? We have 9 weeks, 8.5 weeks together, really more like 7.5 weeks, and 11 of us to write devotionals. So what we'll end up doing is we'll have every week 2 people. One will write, say we're working on the first week, the chapter 1. So one person will write a devotional out of chapter 1 for the morning, and another will write for a devotional for the evening, so that we can kind of bracket our days, right? We can have a parenthesis around our day and develop or maybe further develop a discipline of reading, staying in the Word, thinking, and in this case, thinking specifically about ethics. And if you don't know this about me yet, you will soon. The grounding to me of everything we are, everything we do, particularly in terms of ethics, comes down to our relationship with God through Jesus Christ. So you are going to see a lot of emphasis on that, and all the more reason the devotional's a key part. So again, I want to thank you for joining me in this class and allowing me to join you in this journey. I do think we're going to learn a lot together. If you need me at any time, you see my email on page 2 of the syllabus, seniorpastor2002@yahoo.com, and my phone number, this is my cell phone number, 573-881-7588. If I am out of town, or you reach a message that says, listen, I'm out of town, or please call the office, or I'm not responding to phone calls, I will have this phone with me throughout this course. Do not listen to anything I say on this. If it is a question about the course, or about anything about the course, please call me on my cell, and if I don't pick up, leave a message. I will call you back as soon as possible, okay? No excuses whatsoever. Please know that I've been praying for you, for each one of you, for several weeks. I look forward to an opportunity to get to meet you in person. If you are in Mid-America and you are a Christian Church Disciples of Christer, I hope that I'll get to meet you in Sedalia on October 12th at the Mid-America Regional Assembly. The Mid-America Center for Ministry dinner is coming up in November, I believe November 8th. Don't quote me on that. I just do know it's on November. It is November 8th, a Friday evening. I hope you'll make arrangements to be there, regardless of whether you're in Mid-America or not, and that I get a chance to meet you. When I'm in groups of people, large groups of people, I can be overwhelmed. So if I stare at you funny, just say, from the ethics class, and boom, it'll be right there. Thank you again. I hope that you're having a good day, that you've had a good day, that tomorrow will be even better, and I will continue sharing in prayers with you and bid your prayers for me. I'll talk to you again this way next week, and I will be talking to you this way in the next few days. Take care. Bye-bye.